The data cube is a way of organising satellite data. It chops the satellite images up, if you like, into tiles and stacks those up through time so that we can analyse the data in a way that's not dependent on a particular satellite. The data cube takes us into a quantitative realm where every little pixel in the image is a measurement, and we can look at that measurement back through time. Maybe every day, maybe every week, maybe every month. Those time series capture what's called the dynamics, how things are changing. And that information about dynamics is at least as important as the patterns you see in an image. So we have a lot of data. It goes right back to 1979. Covers the whole of Australia and some of the surrounding countries. The point of that data is to help make better decisions for the Australian government, for the community, for the business, for anybody really. It's preparing the Earth observation community, the remote sensing community, for the deluge of data that's going to come through the door in the next few years. We've got more satellites going up in the next year or so, which are going to produce terabytes of data each day. So we cannot handle those data sets with the traditional methods. They simply won't work. So the data cube provides a framework that we can slot new observations into as they come along each day. And people actually start bringing themselves to the data digitally, not physically, and doing their work on the data rather than taking copies of the data. So there's going to be profound changes in the way we work with Earth observation data. We've already used the data cube to analyse all of Australia where we've seen surface water. So a history of surface water, if you add it all up, tells you about where the floodplains are. And that starts to give you some idea or some better information about flood hazard. We've also used it to process 15 years worth of data across the Murray-Darling Basin to look at how the patterns of greenness change. And they change according to flood and drought. They also change according to when water is released down the Murray-Darling river system. And so we're looking there at whether or not we can monitor responses to water releases through that catchment system. The overriding principle for the data cube and what it's really trying to achieve is to maximise the impact of the data that we've got. And the data cube does that by organising the data, by making sure it's calibrated and high quality and putting it into a high performance computing environment where it can be accessed and used more effectively. The benefits of Geoscience Australia will come through enabling us to do better and bigger work and through better relationships and better cooperations with scientific research agencies, through being able to provide better data to external stakeholders who may want to use it for other studies and analysis. So the data cube is making new work possible that simply wasn't really conceivable only a few years ago.